My name is Tae-Seung Kim, and here's the project manager, Binh, and we've got a finance manager here, Bouziane, and Xuan, and our faculty advisor is Dr. Carl Schaefer. So our main problem is, for example, we got three cases. So we got a marine biologist who's looking for a condom device to go collect water from various open water. It could be like measuring the pH level of certain water. And the second case we could get is U.S. Navy is looking for a condom water vehicle that can go behind any line along the river to gather intelligence. And a local fishing company is looking for autonomous water vehicles for underwater mapping. We can kind of find like different sources, different locations of water for fishing. So basically, our main ideal solution is a boat with a GPS capability that can autonomously maneuver through open water area. So our main objectives are develop an autonomous device that can like navigate to predetermined GPS points to collect data. And second one is to design our consumer in mind on motivation and scalability as a primary target. Third one is our product should be programmable with open architecture. Thus allowing for future additions and modifications, depending on specific needs of different clients. So that is kind of like stated, which is earlier, with the marine biologist goes looking for water. Marine biologists and local fishermen. The last one is simple interactive software applications that will allow users to input their information, such as GPS waypoints. So our basic requirements are accuracy and runtime. So the first one is accuracy. The boat should be able to arrive within 3 meter radius of GPS waypoints before it can start going to the next waypoints. And our runtime is the boat should be able to run a minimum of 1 hour on a fully charged battery. And so Saeed's gonna talk about the top level design right now.
Left diagram, where we have the user is going to be and potentially GPS coordinates and just for stop. We'll expect an output to the boat that we navigate to the white point that was GPS coordinates from the user and move the boat to the I'm also going to have a slot for the data in the middle of us. For the system architecture, we're basically using disadvantage to do the heading and the GPS chip, which is going to provide us with the current coordinate. We're going to use Arduino Uno, which is a microcontroller, which is RPMP28. It's for the user GPS coordinate and calculate the vector to destination. We're going to use the edge bridge, which is L298, and motor driver. We're going to control both models, left and right. And for the communication, for the base, we're going to use an XP model. There will be two XPs, one on the base connected to the laptop, and the other one is going to be built on the boat. We also need, we have to develop a user interface using Visual Basic. That allows the user to select the craft port, which is generated the control number to connect the answer your latitude and longitude of coordinates and they can answer. The data can be sent to the microcontroller and when it's done the boat is gonna start navigating. And in general, it's also jump between different folders, to more than folder. When we got the folder list available, the yet it was the album from the wrong destination, we get coordinator from memory. And when you get a folder to see that coordinator from the GBAT, go to get the current GBAT to the destination GPS. This means go to the destination. If no, we write the method from the current GPS to the destination GPS. Then the calculator, destination ports, get the current port from the GPS port. If the current port is the destination port, it means go to the forward. If no, the current port. This time, we work for two times. The first port is less than 180 degrees. The left motor is maximum. The current port is plus 180 degrees. Then the current port, the necessary port between the current port and turn left maximum degree. If yes, the probe is turn left, this no, the probe is turn right. If the current port not less than 180 degrees, the turn right below degrees is current port minus 180 degrees. Current port, the destination port is between current port and turn left maximum degrees. If yes, the boat is turn right, if no, the boat is turn left. This is a self-driving control steering function. We use the proportional control to control the two motors. If instructor available, the boat will go right. Instructor available, yes, go right. Then change the head, less than 100 degrees. Then the left motor maximum speed. The right motor is 100. Motorize the chain in the head, drive for 100, then motorize for maximum speed. If the door, the left motor is maximum speed, and the right motor is stop. In order to change from the left, if yes, the chain in the head is less than 100 degrees. If the left motor is 100 degrees minus, for chain in the head, drive for 100, then motor for maximum speed, the right motor is maximum speed. Otherwise, if the boat will go forward, the left motor and right motor will go the maximum speed. If no, the left motor and right motor will stop. In general case, we give a microcontroller to control the two motors. If you want to go forward, the microcontroller will tell the two motors go to full speed. If you want to go stop, the microcontroller will tell the two motors stopping. And if we go to the, we want to go make the right turn, the microcontroller will tell the right motor reduce speed and the left motor keep full speed. And opposite, we want to go to the left, the microcontroller will tell the left motor reduce speed and the right motor full speed, then the boat will go to the left.
Checking, are we at the point there? And could not calculate heading and get a heading from the compass and keep going until we had a waypoint. So this loop will load the next waypoint and we will stop this, are we there yet, are we there yet, looping all over again till we reach our destination. So after we've done navigating through all the waypoints, we will stop and we will send the GPS data that will stop through the mission. So this is the thing that since the lunar wall only has one pair of PX and X9, it has to share that with the overlap, the receiver, and of course the wireless communication. So upon starting, it will enable this resistors and disable the rest so that it will only communicate between the XC or the wireless communication. After it's got the user information, it will talk to the GPS receiver, get the data, then disable that gate. Then it will talk to the lock the data, and afterwards, we'll talk to the company and stop the navigation. We made an adapter for the lunar board and solder anything on one another and stack it up on the board. And this is the integration inside that both. So we have enclosure 5.5 inch by 4.5 by 2. And as you can see, that's the GPS receiver, that's the compass. And right there is the local logger and the Bluetooth and the speed. And the motor driver has to show both those. We had a problem earlier with using one battery because the motor driver sucked a lot of current at the battery. That's why we have one battery just for the solder itself and one more battery for the two motors. And next.
Now we are going to talk about the testing plan. You can see this aqua testing a lot of detail The total material was mostly only 531 dollars. And this is the comment. We have around 50 or 60 hours of experience for this project. And because maybe because the company only for production G and cost and for education learning is not. The total for custom math now is around 300. So the total project our project around 2,071. For your lesson learning, make sure you have a plan B for one time. And integration takes a lot of time. Then, maybe we need to take a robotic tour before doing a robotic project. Teamwork and meeting is very important for a successful project. For presentation, we need presentation to Dr. Super in the general program and Dr. Kevin. And we also thank to Dr. Adam Alecto, co-worker of Dr. Shepard, and we predicted how fast it will be my project. Thank you for